This quick tutorial is a must-see for any Final Cut user who's got clips that have been cut short at the beginning. I'll show you how to keep the content in a shortened beginning, even when a transition's used. The start of this clip is just a quick view of the back of a purple car before it drives off frame and the red car comes more into view. I need to keep that shot at the back of the car as it's integral to the story. And at the same time, I need to add a transition to cut from the clip before. If you've used transitions in any video editing package, it's important to note that transitions need a few frames from both clips either side of the cut to be able to exist. And when you try to add a transition to a cut at a clip's first or last frame, you'll get this warning message to say that there's not enough media available to be able to add the transition. If you select Create Transition, a few frames will be hidden behind the transition. And in the case of the purple car I mentioned before, it'll no longer be seen in the edit because those frames are needed by the transition. So what can you do to keep that view of the purple car? It's easy. Just watch this. I'll add two complete clips to the timeline. The first clip shows a black Aston Martin at the end of the clip. The first frames of the second clip show the back of the purple Holden Kingswood. And then the red Ferrari comes more into view. I'll add a transition at the cut. The warning message appears to say the frames will be overlapped. I'll accept, create transition, and then play over the cut. The purple car's hidden. If I delete the transition, the purple car's still hidden because those frames have been used by the transition. But I can extend the beginning of the clip back again so you can see the frames that were used by the transition. So how can I add the transition but still keep the vision of the purple car? One of the hidden ways is to duplicate as a still image using freeze frame from the edit menu or shortcut Option plus F, and then add the transition before the still frame. The still frame needs to be shortened though to be just long enough to fill the space behind the transition without it being too long to show as a freeze frame. The transition is then added at the cut between the end of the first clip and the freeze frame before the second clip. If the car shows too long, go back and shorten the length of the freeze frame. And you can also use the hold command to do the same thing. Or, for another effect, you could cut the clip at the point where the purple car leaves the scene and use speed ramp from 0%. Whatever, they all retain the purple car in view and still allow you to add a transition. These techniques using freeze frame or hold can also be useful to show a face that's only on view for a few frames at the beginning of a clip. I hope you learnt something useful from this tutorial. Look out for more by subscribing and pressing the bell. Thanks for watching.